I'm going to know that having a standard, a strong test that I could go to the pediatrician or to my friend with a PT or any other health professional, like, this is the test, it was norm on 80 countries, and throughout my test, I have seen that these sensory motor functions, these sensory motor skills are impacted. Therefore, I will provide this intervention. So we have to remember, we are not SI therapists, we are occupational therapists trained in SI. So we always focus on the child participation and the child performance and child function in general. So these sensory motor factors are the underlying issues why the child is doing X or Y or Z, right? Either you are hyper, you can be hyper, not either, sorry. You can be hyper, or you can be hypo, or you could be two, okay? So if you are hyper, then you will have exaggerated response to normal level of touch. So if someone touch you like lightly, you may have a reaction, right? So that would be a hyperactivity. Or you will see it a lot on individual with Down syndrome. They will have more issues with registration, right? So we call it hypo. Repeated reaction to normal level of touch. Or you see it with a lot of individuals with ASD, you spin them a lot and they don't even register them. They need more and more and more. So we call it what? Hypo to the symptom. happens to your eye. Sense? Make sense? Alright. So, tactile sensitivity is recorded any of the following behavior observed on an item. Okay. So, if a child expresses discomfort, pulls or turns his arm away from a stimulus, leaning his body away, put arms or hands under the table, verbally express dislike of the stimuli, any discomfort. Child seems anxious, threatened, show increased talking, fidgeting, restless, walk away, seems to have facial expression of fear, anxiety, distress, become increasingly withdrawn, aggravated, grab testing material, ask to end up the test. So anywhere in the fingers is fine.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't have to be where in the finger.
Anywhere in the finger is fine. Oh yeah? Okay, so. You see she used the pencil? Did you see that or no?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see this. Let me play. And then she. Okay? So for ease use and measuring, make a mark 1 centimeter from the end of your pencil and hold it next to the child. Thank you. rather than having all the shapes there marked and asking when, one when I look confused, the child will pass. Right? Did you see how she transitioned the item? So he feels in the left, and then he tries to match it with something on the right. Make sense? So to help you to organize all the sets and all the shapes, it's recommended that you could have all the bottles, up to 12 bottles, in a cup holder. I'm going to explain everything. I just want to show you the video first. Okay, so each bottle we will have the oral shape inserted here. Okay, and have all the oral shapes.
You can make it like this.
You see that she has a shield, right? So he doesn't see what's, which bottle she's taking out from the container. He has up to 10 seconds to figure it out. Okay? Open and close, this is different, huh? Because the first one he did, he opened two of them together. Mm-hmm. right? So if you open and close, it's different than opening it all together. Does that make sense?
Yes. Yes.
I'm going to take you outside. And the paper has to be a little bit plain. These paper are a little plain. يعني لازم العربي كثير شفاف and then you'll see the difference between this and this. بعدين في فرصة. It's easy, it's not that hard. So we'll see the difference. Okay, so I got 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I'll see if I can do it again. So I did 3. So within that, 3.5, okay? And you'll do it on the other hand as well. So we'll see if the child is able to produce the same force. Does that make sense?
Yes. One, two, three, go.
Sorry. You're going to try something that you can feel, hear, or smell. And I want you to tell me what you think.
Oh, I know.
You can say things that you can feel, hear, or smell. And I want you to tell me what you think.
Oh, I know.
You can say, I like it.
I get it.
So you see they're back facing the bottom, right? Back into the chair.
Climb here under this chair and step over to that chair. Perfect.
All right. Now, Ellie, you're
going to sit on this green chair right here.
Did she warn her?
That's it.
No. Right? So she just to see what.
You've been so instrumental, an amazing leader for us in the Middle East, and we just appreciate everyone so much. I don't know how to show my slides, but I don't know if that's necessary. Sultan, you've already been talking about the EZ today. You've been discussing the project.
Yep, we've been talking about
so
it
everyone...
for 8 hours.
Okay. So you probably all have heard enough about the tests themselves. I think what I would like to say is that we are just so inspired to know that so many people, professionals, are coming together to help children all over the world, and that we will have an assessment tool that's appropriate and developed in each culture, in each language. And so our theme, as Sultan probably told you,